You're watching Howard TV's HD Clip of the Week.
I'm concerned for you as the person, not Yucko. I'm concerned for the person.
What about what Artie says? He feels bad for you that, like, when you go to these, you know, things, like Greg Fitzsimmons asks you to do something, and he says, no, I mean, you got to get into makeup.
Well, you know what we ended up doing? It was me, Teddy, and Levy having to end like we were pretending like we had to fucking blow Ron Jeremy, a
not
pizza
pretending.
Guy.
Anybody who watches that video, it's going to look like you're blowing Ron Jeremy.
Thank God Artie threw CDs at Sal and not his breakfast plate. He would have fucking killed him.
You see what's going on?
Jesus Christ.
It's what grilled chicken.
Fucking mound of food.
It's grilled chicken.
You think Artie's getting too heavy?
He's been too heavy. You writing that book? Was it a fucking cookbook? Cooking for Five over there, you fat bastard.
You're mad at him because he made fun of your makeup and your career.
No, I was saying that I felt sorry for him, but I guess, you know, fine. If you don't want a friend to feel sorry for you.
Well, your life's not so bad. Is that what you're saying, Yucko?
No. I'm fucking doing great. Look
at me. Is your girlfriend managing your career?
No, she's not.
Well, how come she was
booking? Where'd you get that shit?
She was booking gigs with me.
Oh, bullshit, Artie. She was not.
You're sitting there comatose, and she's like, okay, we got a theater in Atlanta, and...
She didn't have any fucking contracts or anything like that. She was booking comedy shows long before she even met my fucking ass, all right? Just let it go, you fat fuck over there.
Why does that bother you?
Because I'm sick of that cheering that shit out of him. Come on.
She was booking... Ask Levy, right
come
in front
on.
Of me. And
she asked if you ever been to Atlanta. You're like, yeah, I went there with Norm back in 97.
She's right. I answered her truthfully.
But
and
she said
well,
she had contracts and shit like that. That's bullshit.
I didn't
you
say
know
she
it.
Had contracts.
Yes, you did the last
she
time
said,
I called in.
She said, what was, you know, we got to get something together. So I got a place.
Why does it bother you that Artie thinks your girlfriend is your manager?
Because it's bullshit.
Is
come
she
on.
Your manager or not?
Hell no.
Does she help
is
you
she
book
helping?
Gigs?
No.
Why does that bother you, though? Is it bad for a girlfriend to help you book gigs?
I got a fucking manager.
All right.
She books comedy shows out west and shit a long time ago.
Does she critique
she
your work?
No. Hell no.
She doesn't tell you did a good set, bad set, you need to do this or that?
Yeah, but everybody does that, you know?
No, they don't.
Come on. No, she just asked you, did you want to do a show in Atlanta?
It was way more than that. And
no, it wasn't,
and you sat
Artie.
There like a good boy tamed.
No,
while
it
we
wasn't.
Discussed prices and everything.
No, yeah, you come down there, you say fire fucking five times, you do your Crazy House impersonation.
That's 80,000.
You get 80,000, yeah. Calm the fuck down.
Wow. Yucko.
That's a nerve with him.
Are you sick and tired of these other comedians making fun of your career because you got to wear clown makeup?
Yeah, big fucking deal, you know? I'm doing fine at it.
I
know.
You got to get dressed too, right?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, he had to put on pants. And
Artie's got to put on his fucking cargo pants and stroll out there. Fire! Yeah!
I have one pair of pants that fits me now.
You guys want to hear my cheers bit from 1983?
It's wow. Getting me paid.
You're making more than me, you lard ass.
Thank God.
Fat man. Cupcake.
That's original.
Lard ass.
Listen.
Fat man.
Looking at your career, I think your manager's fucking you as well.
Nah. Oh, yeah, he sits on his ass out in Santa Monica. I never hear from the
that's
fucker.
That's what I mean. So it looks like your girlfriend is taking the bull by the horn.
No way.
You've just watched Howard TV's HD Clip of the Week.